Welcome to this video on creating a grouping command for selected objects in Unity Editor. I want to show you a way to group selected items in the editor using MenuItem Attribute and Properties of Selection class. Here I have some eyes constructed from a default 3D objects. We can say the hierarchy is not so nice to look at. If I were to select parts of one eye and press CTRL G in Windows and Command G in Mac, I will get a new group object with the selected object as child under its transform. The position of the newly created object is calculated as the center position of the selected child objects. In addition, the CTRL G hotkey, you can call this command from the menu buttons in the editor. For example, for this implementation, we can call our new command from GameObject, Custom Commands, Group Selected. Here, next to the name of the command, we can see the hotkey. I can apply grouping to all the eyes. And if I were to decide grouping the iris and pupil will be good too, I can do that under the common parent transform. With all the groupings finished now, I can duplicate the eye and group them again and have an eye set ready to be placed on a face or another structure. With this implementation, there are some warnings I want to inform you about. To have this work in the best case, selected objects should belong to the same parent. If you want to group already created groups, you should select the group's transform, the parent transform. Otherwise, they will be fused under the group's parent and leave the previous group parents empty. For the prefabs, it is okay to group roots of the prefab but not the children in the editor. You can group prefab children in prefab editor. Lastly, this does not support undo yet. So the grouping you have applied is permanent. There is undo class in editor, which I will look into for the next videos. Just let me know if you're interested. With these warnings out of our way, if you are still interested, let's take a look at the code. So this is the class that helps us to group selected objects called group selection command. Here it's a static class. In Unity doc examples for menu item attribute, the classes are mono behavior inherited. But I don't want to use this script as a component and don't want to inherit mono behavior. That is why I use it as a public static class. But the other usage is okay too. Here in our class, we have a static function called GroupSelected. This has a MenuItem attribute here, giving us a path in the menus to run the command from the editor UI and also at the end the hotkey for the command. I find it fit to put this in the GameObject menu under Custom Commands as GroupSelected. Here the first symbol represents the special keys on the keyboard, as stated in the docs. Modulo 4, Control on Windows, Command on Macs. There are hash for shift and simple for alt. And the last vector is what is pressed in the combo, G key in the keyboard. Modulo and G converted to Ctrl G can be combination in the editor. If you want other combinations, go ahead. Try them out. Creating commands is fun. And as long as there are free hotkey spots, you're free to create as many as you would like. That's enough for MenuItem. Let's have a look at what our command does. It is divided into four parts. Validate, check if you can group the selection. Find center position of the selected objects, make selection the children of the empty group object, lastly check if everything went well. So this is the breakdown of this approach. You can omit some steps if you would like and directly go for parenting, but others should be beneficial for the outcome too. For validation, we check if there is any object selected in the editor. The selection class gives us the necessary information from its active transform property, which is the transform of the first object included in the selection. If there is no first object, so is no selection. If there is no selection, there is no need to run the next lines of code. After giving an information warning on the situation, we return from running the rest of the function. Also, here is a logic command dot for prefabs. As mentioned, it is okay to group prefab groups but not the child's as it breaks the prefab structure. You can do that grouping in prefab editor. To not get grouping errors regarding prefabs, we could look through the selected objects and check if any of them are prefab related. If so, we will not group. But this excludes prefab roots, which would be better to include, so here is command dot for future development. Now calculating the center position. Initiate the center position vector to be 000, and selection object is the game object list which has the references of all the game objects selected in the editor. For each selected game object and selection.objects, we add the position of the selected to the center position vector. After looping through all the positions in the selection, we calculate the center position by dividing the vector selected object count. Now we have center position of the group object that will be created next. First, we create the empty game object. name it GroupObject and set its transform to GroupParentTransform. Then move the object to previously calculated center position of the selected GameObjects. Here we are checking if the first selected object, selection.ActiveTransform, has a parent. If it has a parent, we set the parent of GroupParent to ActiveTransform's parent. These steps helps with in-level grouping, such as iris and pupil under I. And here is one of the reasons to get the healthiest outcome. We need to confirm all the objects are from the same level under the same parent in the hierarchy. Otherwise, objects not sharing the same parent with ActiveTransform will be grouped under its parent. After that, we put all the game objects in the selection under the transform of the group parent. With that, grouping is done. Lastly, if there happens to be a case that slips through our validation and our parent object does not have any children, we destroy it, with a warning message to inform the developer of the situation. Here we are using GameObject.DestroyImmediate. GameObject because the class is not inherited from the mono behavior. If it was, using GameObject wouldn't be necessary. And DestroyImmediate instead of destroy, because destroy function may not run in edit mode as the editor itself tells in an error message when we try to call it. And that concludes the script walkthrough. With this, we are at the end of this tutorial. I may continue working on it a little bit more. To me, this script will be a script I will be importing to the projects that needs grouping functionality or hand-on tidying up the hierarchy quickly. Also, I am very happy to be able to create a command for the editor. Editor scripting is something I would like to learn at one point in my game dev life, and I believe it makes things easier from the editor side. I hope that this tutorial will be helpful in your projects too. If there was a point not clear, let me know in the comments. And if you liked the video, give it a like and subscribe for the future ones. With that, I hope to see you in the next explorations, and bye bye!